Right, where to start with this episode? Because I have gassed this episode since the beginning of Core 2. I've talked about how this episode is going to be a priority episode. And if I get made dumb now, or if I get made look silly, and it isn't a good episode, I'm going to have so much backlash. But what's going on, everybody? It is that time for Bleach Episode 20. Kenpachi versus Gremy. I am the Edge. And if that title doesn't rock your socks off, then yeah, I don't know what will. But as I just said at the start of this episode, we have a lot to talk about. So stick around and let's enjoy these new acquired pictures together. So of course, on screen, you will be seeing the pictures of episode 20. We'll be talking about them. Obviously, I'm going to give a synopsis right now. The translation is even worse than ever before, but I'm just going to give you an overall rundown. Isana and Yachiru, who are treating Kensei and the others, Will Rose, were attacked by, I don't like saying this guy's name, Gweniel, an annihilator, also known as a Quincy, with the ability to erase not only their appearance, but their opponent's memories of them at will. Yachiru and her friends, I assume Isana again, repeatedly meet for the first time, but Yachiru uses her instincts and reflexes to strike back at the invisible enemy, and then draws her Zanpakuto to attack further with thanks Google Translate. His ability to Shikai surprises Isana, and he was able to corner Gwenya. At that moment, however, another enemy appears soundlessly inside the ward. Right, so basically, in a nutshell of what's happening here, is that Yachiru does some business, uses Shikai against this invisible enemy. Isana is surprised, and of course, during all of this, another enemy appears, which is going to be Gremy. And then in the images that you can see on screen, it's also going to be Kenpachi that turns up as well. So are we getting two Storm Ritters? Are we just getting one? Who knows? You'll have to find out when you watch the episode. But what I can say is this fight is going to be exciting. I think any fight with Kenpachi is going to be a priority episode. People love Kenpachi. Kenpachi is the embodiment of battle, is the embodiment of high class fighting. And I think the animators know this, the studio know this, the fans know this. So there's always an expectation when it comes to anything involving Kenpachi. Now, of course, we do have the staff listing, and as much as you guys know, I don't like to talk about staff that much. I think the staff is somewhat all right. It's not anything that's making me, you know, eye pop and be like, whoa, this person. No. Of course, we do know that people like Yamashita are going to be within this episode. However, Yamashita doesn't like to be credited in most of the things that he does. So, along with Yamashita, will usually come a bunch of other people too. Maybe Kukawa as well as key animator. So, again, there's many different things that could be happening in this episode. And, of course, with people not really having too high hopes with the staff listing so far, which I think is completely fine because, of course, there's a lot of context. People were saying the same thing about the Rukia episode where they were like, oh, you know, the staff isn't that good and, you know, it's a Rukia episode and it turned out to be one of the best in this core. So I'm not too bothered at the moment in regards to this staff currently because we do know that there is some brilliant people involved within the key animation stage. So again, I'm still very interested and my high hopes are still incredibly high. That being said, one of the major complaints about this, if you want to call it a complaint, which is something we do need to discuss, is the chapter count. Of course, if you're a manga reader, you would know that the way that this is ending is going to be between 8 to 9 chapters. Now, of course, that is extremely fast-paced. We're used to getting at least 4 to 5 chapters per episode, but in this case, we're getting about 8 to 9, which, of course, is making everybody lose their minds. Now, this isn't a big deal, considering that every episode we get extra content, regardless, you know, whether it be Ichigo, whether it be Uryu and Harshwald, we always get extra content within every episode, so that's 5 chapters plus extra content, which is fantastic. This time, we're getting 9 chapters with maybe extra content as well. And why that isn't a bad thing and why people are like, oh, well, that's too fast paced. No, it's not. Because every chapter of the manga for this fight specifically is literally whoever Kenpachi is fighting or whoever Yachiru is fighting. It is a spoilers video. So whoever Kenpachi is fighting, he's just getting stuff thrown at him. I could barely call it a fight, if you want to call it a fight, until like later on within like probably the second half of the episode. But it is for the majority. Gremy just thrown as much stuff at Kenpachi as he can. And it really is not dialogue heavy at all. It literally is monkey brained slash sword with object thrown. And it's fine in that context because there's nothing to elaborate on. There's not much voice acting to elaborate on. It is just all special effects. So the fast pacedness of the 9 chapters is not that big of a deal. And if you look at the manga itself, the majority of the pages, they're either single page spreads or double page spreads. So yeah, it's fast paced because there's just a lot of cool artwork in this fight. So if anything, I'm more excited to see the creativity that people like Yamashita can pull off. I know specifically that he is specifically working on the gun scene of Gremmy, which is pretty cool because that's one of my favorite panels throughout this entire fight. I mean, obviously people are going to like the meteor too, and I don't know who's working on that. Yamashita could be working on it. Kyukawa could be working on it. Who knows? Somebody's going to be working on it, and it's going to look beautiful. I would imagine it's going to probably be like one of the biggest things of the episode, to be honest with you. But I think people need to calm down on pacing and consider the context of this episode, because I'm completely fine with it. And I think the dialogue stuff is going to happen between the start of the episode, obviously with like Yachu and Isane, X, Y, and Z. And then of course, towards the end where Gremmy kind of admits, you know, his eventual defeat per se. And then we might get some maybe after end credits, even if we do even have an ending this episode again, like episode 19 with Rukia. We might not even have an ending, so that would be cool. To be honest with you, I'd prefer that as well, because that's an extra minute and a half or extra minute. And then probably towards the end, I would imagine that's where like it's the Bambis versus, you know, Kenpachi. So that's my kind of prediction about all of this. And I think, you know, people's every reaction about it, because this should be an exciting episode. And I think the more that these episodes are going to get exciting, the more people are going to doom post or, you know, get worried about it or lower expectations, because it is exciting. Fights like these are really, really exciting, but people, I think, are scared to get their expectations met or expectations high because they don't want to be disappointed. And I get that from that perspective. So other than that, here's the images. I do want to ask for those that actually managed to watch the entire video, put cookies in chat, put a cookie emoji in the chat. If you know, you know. And I'm going to miss Yachiru, to be honest with you. I mean, we'll get to see her again, but like, I'm going to miss Yachiru because she is a bundle of joy and she is important to Kenpachi. So other than that, tell me what your guys' thoughts in the comment section down below is on this episode. What do you think of the staff? What do you want from this episode? What extra stuff would you like to see? And are you fine with the pacing? For me personally, I think it's going to be cool. And how would you like the episode to end? I think it is going to be the brain at the end. But if we do end up getting extra scenes, I would like the candies and the Bambi girls going up against Kenpachi. I think that'd be cool. I don't think so, but that's just kind of my initial thoughts. With that being said, I'm going to catch you guys. You guys, of course, have this fight. I've been Hanson. And as always, people, peace out.